So far, except consistently colder.
Why?
Sam.
Thanks for tuning in.
For those who are just joining us, we're a pretty average couple who decided to make travel and adventure a way of life.
A couple of years ago, we took the next step and made a boat our home so we could bring our creatures and comforts along for the ride.
Together we sail the seas, trek the globe, or even just take a drive, as long as it's somewhere new.
We left Bellhaven covered in ice and early to catch high tide through the shallow channel.
We are shoving off. It's freaking cold outside.
I cannot feel my thighs.
Southbound trip update. It has been much like the northbound trip, except consistently colder, and we don't have a selfie stick because it rusted. So,
like
yeah.
Tin roof!
Rusted. But still just cruising along in the ICW for now, getting south of Hatteras. Heading to the Beauforts and gonna pop out into the ocean from there. We're looking at some warm, calm weather next week after a little bit of a blow. So we're gonna weather out the wind in Beaufort and then hopefully make a big push. Actually get out in the ocean, do some sailing instead of, you know, this. Which isn't bad. It's nice and calm, but it ain't sailing, you know?
So let's talk about the tree. Yeah.
Let's talk about that tree.
Have we mentioned the tree? Do they know about the tree?
Well, they will. Okay. By the time...
So we are... I'm lounging. Chaise lounge style on the back of the boat here. Erica's up there captaining. She's doing an excellent job of captaining. I will...
Oh, okay. So we're not talking about right now. You're taking us back.
I'm taking us back.
Putting us in the moment.
Putting us in the spot.
I got
like
you.
I'm chaise lounging over here reading a book.
Mm-hmm.
Erica's captaining. So we're going along and I feel this kind of little lump and I was like, oh, that's weird. I should get up. And so as soon as I start to get up, the entire boat goes from the 6 knots we were doing to 0 knots. The front end lifts up and then slaps back down. And then the back end lifts and spins around so that we do a full 90, probably more than 90 degree turn, just dead stop in the water.
In the course of like a half a second.
Like instantly. It threw me on the ground and I was like, okay, the boat's gonna sink.
Yeah, I mean, literally, I thought that was it. I was like, we are done for. Throwing the life raft.
So I jump up. I grab onto the helm and I'm trying to figure out what's going on. I can't steer. I'm like, I've lost all steering. The engines are dead. I'm in the middle of this river. I've got a guy on the back behind me. He's like, hey, I'm just going to go ahead and pass you on your right. I'm like, the spot where I just hit the tree? Like,
yeah.
Knock yourself out, bro.
Exactly.
Like, you do you.
Thanks for your concern. We're fine.
Yeah.
Sinking, but fine.
And so I can't get the helm to steer, like, at all. I'm like, what is going on?
Also, I had pulled out, I had done the correct things. I didn't just, like, freak out and run away and, like, jump into the life raft.
She did everything she was supposed to do.
I took it out of gear, and I was trying to do the stuff, and when I couldn't get it to work, I was like, all right, IT. All right, IT.
So, yeah, I get up there, and I can't figure it out initially, and so I get both the engines turned back on. They're both running. I don't hear any weirdness coming off of anything.
I'm checking the front lockers. I'm checking the bilges
open.
I'm like, we taking all water? What is going on?
And then I realized we had autopilot engaged. I turned that off, and I could finally steer again, and that was fine. And we got, you know, back the right way. But then, you know, we still had 30 miles to our next stop. And I'm like, the boat may or may not be sinking. Cool. Let's knock out 30 miles. But hey, spoiler alert, not sinking.
So thanks, Lagoon, circa 1999.
Yeah.
Because you built a strong boat.
Built a tank. I appreciate you.
That's what I appreciate about you.
Fortunately, the rest of the way to the coast was pretty much drama-free. Though still, unfortunately, cold and overcast. As we were pulling into town, something caught Brian's eye. So once we got settled, we wasted no time going to explore this super cool place.
Tell me about history, Brian.
I'm so glad you asked. So this is Phillips Island, just off of Morehead City in North Carolina, and it used to be a fishing, they processed fish here. So this big building that we're standing in is the smokestack for the fishery, and it closed sometime in the 1930s, 1940s, and then 1953, 54, somewhere around there, the whole rest of the building burned to the ground, and all the people from the local towns went and stood on the bridges over there to watch it burn, because there wasn't much else they could do. And so if you look up, there we go, that's all the way to the top of the smokestack. So, history.
I love it. What did you say about this whole area? Because we're in a swamp.
Yes.
We're in a swamp.
This is an island amongst tiny islands in kind of a swamp.
But this whole area used to be a town that was...
So it was named a town, but then it was never actually finished. They were like, hey, this is a town. We're going to put a town here, and they never actually towned.
Because just, it's water. It's literally just water.
It's muck.
The more you know!
Hit it again. Several times in a row. Yeah. That's some clear water. It was. Put my dirty feet in there. So I feel like this is a pretty good time and place to talk about all of the things that have gone wrong so far. There's a lot that's gone right. We had some really good days. It's December 11th, and it's 70 degrees. And we're exploring abandoned things on a tiny island. So, yeah. I'm pretty happy today. But, let's see. Our autopilot's not working. Yeah. We've had to take apart... Bryant and our friend Eric have taken apart our engine. There's a boat going by that's really... loud.
I fixed one of the issues that's gone wrong. The biggest issue right now is that the autopilot doesn't work. Yeah, so the engine had an overheating issue, which ended up being kind of a clogged artery in the intake, the water intake. But I took the entire engine apart, took the heat exchanger all the way apart, did all that.
And then we had a gasket that we had to change out.
Yeah, head gasket, that's right.
Head gasket, yeah.
Head gasket went, yep. So we got to take the engine apart again.
The batteries have a bug in them.
Yeah.
Somewhere.
There's something weird going on with the lithium. I don't know what to do about that yet.
Our boat has been facing the wrong way on our navigation for almost the whole trip.
I fixed that though.
Fixed that.
Figured that part out.
Yeah. So yeah, mainly our autopilot. We're just about to do our first big push out in the open ocean and an overnight at that. And yeah,
looking like probably about 39-ish hours out at sea and no autopilot to speak of. It's going to be awesome.
So, yeah.
Unless something miraculously fixes with it tomorrow. Yeah,
it might. Brian has the habit of looking certainly at things that are broken and then just fixing themselves out of sheer terror.
Yeah.
Maybe.
Yeah. Get it straight. But we are out here doing what we love, which is exploring things. And this is Phillips Island. Yeah.
Tonight is the prep night for going offshore tomorrow, and we're just sitting around trying to chill a little bit.
Bill.
Cooking up some food for... Stop rubbing on the phone, Lord. Cooking up some food for the trip, because it's going to be, like we said, between 24 and 48 hours. It depends on the wind. But we generally don't want to cook too much. I just don't feel like it. So, did some laundry. Brian did most of this stuff. I was so tired today. Stowing things away. Getting together the GoPro filming mounts and things like that so that we can try and get better about filming a little bit more action while we're actually out sailing instead of ruminating upon things after the fact. I don't know, I'm trying to relax a little.
Yeah, it's got to be a fairly low-key day today because we're going to have so much to do over the next couple of days. You don't want to go into that sort of thing already tired.
We're going to put a bed on the floor tomorrow when we get up. We're going to take some more stuff down off of shelves and just put them in places that they won't roll around in. But other than that, it's kind of a short jump tomorrow. The weather, the wind, the waves, they all look very mild. So I don't think it's going to be hectic. I hope not. So I'm not really stressing this one. See you tomorrow. Come here. Well, come here. You want me to star of the show so bad.
This tiny.
Hi, George.
I got bit by a cat.
Good old fashioned sit down cat. Let's here, let's take the microphone off. Let's put it gently on the table here. Stroke it a little bit.
Oh.
And then maybe do a little bit of a pose just in case you want to do a thumbnail off of this. Oh, I like this.
Yeah, that's a keeper.